Namaste and welcome back to my channel, The Research Junction, where we simplify complex research-related queries. For those who don't know me, my name is Pallavi Datta and I'm currently pursuing my PhD. I've always noted a confusion that arises between the terms research problem, research questions and research objectives. How different are they? Isn't it all pointing towards the same thing? Then why are we asked to write these separately? Well, after watching this video, you're never going to face this confusion again. So let's get started. Let's start by first understanding what is a research problem. A research problem is a specific issue or a gap in knowledge that a researcher aims to investigate, explore, or address through a research study. It represents a puzzle or a challenge in a particular field or subject area that requires further investigation or understanding. For an example, increasing employee attrition in XYZ company. Employee attrition is nothing but the increasing number of resignations and quitting of employees from a company. And it's a problem for the company because they spend a lot of money on recruiting these individuals and spend on their trainings. Therefore, let's finalize that this is the problem the company management is facing and wants to research on how to tackle this challenge. Research questions arise to try finding solutions to the problem. So a researcher in this case would want to know why employees are leaving the company and how can we solve that issue. Therefore, the research question in this case becomes, what are the factors leading to employee retention? Why are employees quitting? The research questions usually ends with a question mark and starts with the word why, how, what, and so on. But please note that the way you frame your research question should align with the research method you're using for your study. In this case, we are using the word why they are quitting. The answer can be found mostly through the open-ended interview methods instead of a limited optioned survey questionnaire. Therefore, this question is used in qualitative research method. The factors influencing them can also be found through the interview method. Therefore, depending upon your research questions, your research method will vary. Now, once we have our research question, we design the research objective. Objectives are sentences to which you need to find specific solutions from your data analysis. Examples: to find, to explore, to understand, or to analyze. Each of this objective should have an answer to it in the findings section. In this case, our objective will be to find the factors leading in increased attrition rate in the XYZ company. There is usually a very small difference in the research objective and research question statements. Questions will have a question mark, which the objective should not have. And the objective statements should start with the word to, which the research questions should not have. We'll complete this discussion with another example.
Suppose the topic is the impact of social media on mental health among adolescents. So here the research problem will be that the widespread use of social media platforms among the adolescents has raised concerns about its potential impact on their mental health. However, the specific effects and underlying mechanisms of this relationship are still unclear. Therefore, the questions for this problem would be, how does social media usage affect the mental health of adolescents? So this ends with a question mark. Then what are the potential risk factors associated with it? What are the protective factors that may mitigate the negative effects of social media? And so on. Parallelly, the research objectives would be starting with the word to. So in this context, the objectives would be to examine the correlation between social media use and various mental health outcomes, to identify specific risk factors such as cyberbullying, social comparison, and online harassment, then to explore potential protective factors, and so on.
Hope this video has cleared your confusion. In case of any doubts, please feel free to message in the comment section. You can find more such short and simplified videos on research-related topics in my channel. Please do like and subscribe to the channel. See you soon.